I was living in Bombay. I was working there, and my brother-in-law also was there with my cousin sister. He used to work for SBI, but he was very passionate about cars. And I, being from mechanical engineering background, we always used to have discussion. He would always try to say that, you know, even though I'm not a qualified mechanical engineer, I've got more knowledge and I'm more informed about, you know, how these cars work, how these engines work, and all this kind of thing. And he was a devout, he's a devotee of Shirdi Sai Baba, and he used to go almost maybe monthly, twice, thrice, like that. And it's quite a distance from Bombay to Shirdi, and I used to drive him. I don't mind, you know, going for a long drive, and I used to drive him. He had a new car. He didn't know driving, and he was going. And one such occasion, when we were going for a drive to Shirdi, the car stopped in a hilly, curvy road. And there was nobody else. Of course, there were cars going, but nobody was stopping. So we both, I was driving. I came out of my side and he came out of his side. Then we opened the bonnet and we were trying to figure out what happened. I very humbly, meekly, immediately surrendered, saying that I don't know. What is the problem? I have no idea. He said, these are all small things. I have done this many times. And, you know, he got into and trying doing this thing, spark plug, this thing, starter, alternator, tried all kind of things, nothing worked. Then I, being, you know, younger to him, he asked me to go down and get some mechanic, and I had to go down, walk, and luckily I could find a garage shop, and there was somebody who was there. So the garage mechanic, along with his assistant and me, three of us, we came in a bike, and we reached there, and the person, the mechanic, actually asked my brother-in-law to start the engine. The engine was cranking. The engine was starting, but then it will stop. Again, he asked him twice, do it one more time, and it stopped. This mechanic didn't even open the bonnet to see what is the problem. He just heard that sound. But by hearing the sound, he could tell that this is the problem. And he told it to his assistant that, you know, you do this, you take this chotu, you take this spanner and, you know, do something, it'll be all done. And he left. And I was feeling, you know, deep fear within, you know, if that car doesn't get started up at that point in time, then again, I have to go down to get that man, and which is not, you know, it's quite a distance. But lo and behold, the car got started. Magic. There were two of us who were trying to figure out what is the problem. We could not figure out, but the person who has got knowledge about that thing could see and figure out that what is the problem. He could detect, he could diagnose, and he could tell that. Similarly, in our life, you know, we pursue so many varieties of knowledge. Somebody wants to become a good software engineer. Somebody wants to become a good manager. Somebody wants to become a good entrepreneur. Somebody wants to become a good medical professional. Somebody wants to become a good philosopher. Somebody wants to become a good teacher, professor, so many professions. And we're trying to acquire knowledge. So by that knowledge, when we have that knowledge, I will use it so that I can get some gain in life, either some monetary benefits. Mostly that is the case where, you know, I have got more skills. So I know how I can become, you know, successful in terms of material gains, or I can have some intellectual pleasure because I've got that knowledge. I've been pursuing for that. I can get some intellectual knowledge. Pursuit of this knowledge is very, you know, it is there in every one of us. But there is another kind of knowledge which is required, which is called Divya Gyan. And that Divya Gyan is available in this Bhagavatam. And the difference between any other knowledge which is there and Divya Gyan is all other knowledge are relative. They're not the ultimate knowledge, because this relative knowledge gives us some kind of, you know, ways and means of how to live our life. But Divya Gyan is that ultimate knowledge because it prepares us for that ultimate destination. It uplifts us from this material platform. When we hear that knowledge, our outlook towards life changes. It makes us a better person from within. And that kind of knowledge is called Divya Gyan. And there are two characteristics of Divya Gyan as given in Bhagavatam. Bhagavatam is filled with this Divya Gyan. The second verse itself talks about, what is the verse? Vedyam Vastavam Atra Vastu Sivadam Tapatrayon Moolanam. Vedyam Vastavam Atra Vastu Sivadam Tapatrayon Moolanam. This knowledge has to be factual, has to be true, has to be real. Vastavam. Vedyam Vastavam Atra Vastu Sivadam. And it has to be auspicious. it should bring some kind of well-being. Vedyam vastavam atravastu sivadam tapatrayon mulanam, and it uproots the threefold miseries. That knowledge is the knowledge of Srimad Bhagavad, and that knowledge prepares us for that ultimate destination, liberation from this material world. It uplifts us, it brings us to that transcendental platform. So and when we have that spiritual knowledge, our vision, our understanding, our perspective of life completely changes. So it is so important to pursue that knowledge, and it can be pursued, it can be understood when we are in association of devotees and trying to understand this. And I'm not making it, there is a verse in 11th canto, I don't have it right now, but I can share it. It says, actually, to see material things, we need eyes, and we need sun in the sky. When sunshine falls, when the sun rises, not just like that, rises completely, then we are able to see things all around. But to see things, what happens in our life, we need devotees who can show us, who can tell us, who can explain these things to us. And then we see, and that seeing is a different thing. Even in Bhagavad Gita, it is mentioned, there is verse in that 15th chapter where it is mentioned, Vimudha nanu pasyanti pasyanti jnana chakshusha. There is one way of seeing, which you know all of us are accustomed to based on our upbringing, based on our the value system that we have. We see things in a particular way. But to see things through the jnana chakshu, it requires some amount of, you know, different kind of mindset and different kind of culture of knowledge.